It was known as the ice cream of the future. It consists of tiny frozen beads. Today, it's mostly found in amusement parks and stadiums.
We'll walk out there for an ice cream.
Ice cream! Oh!
But why is it not available at the local grocery store? And what does its development have to do with an old hand crank ice cream maker? Cryogenics, patent fraud, and feeding cows.
Really?
Stay tuned as we dip into the facts.
They're sweet, but they're cold and they're melting, disappearing.
Dippin Dots were created in 1987 by microbiologist Curt Jones. They are tiny beads of ice cream, but they're much different than traditional ice cream. It's because of the way these frozen balls of joy are made. As a child, Jones grew up on a small farm in the U.S. state of Illinois. He and his neighbors would make ice cream with an old hand crank ice cream maker. He would fill the machine with cream and sugar, then add ice and salt to lower the temperature below freezing. But it took too long.
I waited a long time, I can't wait anymore.
As much as Jones enjoyed the frozen treat, he was frustrated by how long it took for the ice cream to freeze.
Let's go!
Fast forward to the adult Curt Jones. A microbiologist, he worked at a biotechnology company. He studied freezing bacterial cultures to add them into livestock feed. The goal was to create an alternative to antibiotics. After cows ate the frozen bacteria, it would be revived in the animals and act as part of the livestock's microbiomes to help their digestion. He determined that the best way to freeze the cultures was using liquid nitrogen, which could be as low as negative 196 degrees Celsius. Recalling his childhood days of ice cream making, Jones realized that he could use this method of cryogenics to freeze ice cream rapidly. He combined the ice cream ingredients and flash froze them using liquid nitrogen. The cryogenically frozen ice cream formed into tiny balls that each took a second to freeze.
Wow.
Traditional ice cream can take 3 to 4 hours to freeze properly. This process is what makes Dippin Dots so unique. Its ice cream beads are much harder than traditional ice cream. There's no air trapped inside, and the ice crystals are 40 to 50 times smaller. But Dippin Dots were not an immediate success.
But why?
It wasn't until they were marketed as the ice cream of the future that product sales began to take off.
It is time for ice cream.
Its success led to imitators, such as Mini Melts and Molly Cools.
So what happened then?
Jones took Mini Melts to court over his patent for cryogenic encapsulation. But he lost the case due to a technicality. Jones had filed for his patent more than a year after he had begun selling Dippin Dots. In the US, inventors must apply for a patent within 1 year of inventing their product, or it's considered to be public art. Despite his patent hiccup, Jones's flash-frozen ice cream treats continue to do well. But you won't find Dippin Dots at your local grocery store. That's because they need to be stored at temperatures of about negative 40 degrees Celsius. Instead, in North America, approximately 5.7 million liters of Dippin Dots are sold each year at 100 shopping centers, 107 amusement parks, and over 1,000 entertainment locations like stadiums and cinemas. However, it's not cheap, as a regular-sized cup sells for about $8.29 US. The dessert is made in different flavors. It's been described as giving a sudden, intense, and fresh sensation.
They're good. I'll take 10, though.
The dots can be crunchy at first and stick to the tongue. They've also been described as feeling like styrofoam pellets. Unlike ice cream, it is recommended that you do not try making Dippin Dots at home. Liquid nitrogen can be dangerous. In July 2021, 10 people were injured due to an explosion at a Dippin Dots manufacturing plant in Kentucky. The U.S. Food and Drug Administration has warned against making or consuming foods made with liquid nitrogen. It could result in serious injury, including internal organ damage. But don't worry, Dippin Dots are safe. The nitrogen used to make them has had enough time to dissipate by the time you get your hands on it. So enjoy your Dippin Dots, but don't try to make them yourself. Now that we've discovered the origins of Dippin Dots, let's find out the nasty origins of ketchup on another episode of Origins of Food.